There was a player in high school basketball who was a four-star recruit and arguably one of the most versatile players at the high school level. He was listed at roughly 6'6", 200 pounds, and in the top 65 overall players in his class. It doesn't just stop there. To go along with all of that, he had offers from every major D1 program in the country. Every school in the country wanted this guy because he was a flat-out beast. There's no other way to put it. He was putting up over 20 points and 10 rebounds every single game. What made all these colleges fall in love with this player is the fact that he fit the modern-day play style of a big man. He wasn't your average 6'6", 200-pound player. He was fast, quick, and he could block shots and protect the rim. He could handle the ball, and he even had a nice jump shot to go along with that. And if that wasn't enough for you, he was also on a couple of YouTube mixtape videos that went viral. So whether you found out about this kid on YouTube or from watching him in basketball, everyone could agree that he was up next and he was going to be special. You don't get offers from every major D1 program for no reason. You gotta be really good. Some recruiting analysts even went as far as to saying that he could be a lottery pick or get drafted in the first round. And as crazy as that sounds, it doesn't really seem that crazy because if you saw him in high school, you would believe it. But however, ever since high school, he not only disappointed, but he didn't even play in college. The word disappointment would be an understatement for what happened to him. I don't know if it's the number one hardest, but he has one of the top and hardest fall-offs from a top high school player that I've ever seen. And maybe if it isn't the hardest, there's one thing for sure, it's definitely the quickest. And just within the span of 1 year, he went from people saying he could be a first rounder NBA player to a guy that can't even hoop anymore. So it leaves us with the question today, what really happened to Cameron Fletcher? What's good, y'all? Hope you're having a blessed day. Just wanted to drop by and say we're on the road to 100k, so if you're loving the basketball content, what are you doing? Join the family. Hit that subscribe button and leave a like for more. Now, without further ado, let's get into the story. Oh man, Cameron Fletcher. Now, I know there's going to be a few Kentucky fans or a lot of Kentucky fans watching this video, and you think you know, and you probably do know some of the pieces. With that being said, for my Kentucky fans watching, you don't know everything that happened and what went on behind the scenes. So even if you think you do know most of the story, just stick it out because there's some stuff that you're probably going to want to hear about. And for everyone else, you're probably sitting there like, yo Matt, what are you talking about? Well, let's just get into it. In high school basketball, Cameron Fletcher, I'm going to call him Cam because that's what most people call him, he was nothing short of a beast. Like I stated, he was averaging over 20 points per game and 10 rebounds. And coming in at roughly 6'6" and 200 pounds, he was a tank out there. Yes, he had great size, but what impressed a lot of people was the fact that he was so fast and quick. Most people that are above 6'5" or 6'6" aren't really as quick as point guards. I already know there's going to be people talking about NBA players, but guess what? They're in the NBA for a reason, because it's rare. People like Ben Simmons and anybody over 6'6", like LeBron, that are fast as point guards, it's not normal. Therefore, that's why they're in the NBA. For the most part, that's why he was so highly recruited in high school and highly valued. A main reason a lot of players are even ranked in the ESPN rankings is because they're really athletic. Don't get me wrong, you're gonna have a couple of shooters, but more than likely, they're all high flyers. And this was a perfect example for Cam Fletcher himself. He played high school basketball for a school named Vashon High School in St. Louis, Missouri. During his junior and senior year, this is when he really came onto the scene. He was dominating his competition and all the offers from colleges started to roll in. To go along with that, he also had some videos on YouTube that were going viral of his team playing. During his senior year and at that point in time, things couldn't have gotten any better for this kid. Just like most of the players we talk about and make stories about, they're on top of the world in high school because they're the man. But when they go to college, unfortunately, everyone that's at that college was the man in high school. So that's when the alpha males separate themselves from the betas. Every school in the country wanted Cam Fletcher, for obvious reasons. But to make a long story short, he wound up signing with Kentucky. It was relatively close to where he played his high school basketball at, and he was also a part of a good and huge recruiting class that was also a disappointment. When he got to Kentucky and throughout all the practices, there was a lot of hype and people were talking about how great he was. I already know what some of you are thinking I'm about to say. This is where our story takes a drastic turn, but not quite yet. To start start this season for Kentucky, and Cam Fletcher, things couldn't have got any better. He was living up to the hype, and he was performing like people expected him to. In his first game, in 17 minutes played, he went 4-for-5 from the field. One of those four makes also included a three-pointer, which was rare because he didn't shoot many of those in high school. He also pitched in 5 rebounds, 3 assists, and 1 steal, and finished with 9 points. I understand 9 points, it doesn't jump out at the board at you, but for Cam Fletcher, this was a good start. This was giving the fan base of Kentucky some hope. They also won that game 81-45 against Morehead State. To follow that up, only 4 days later against Richmond in a game they lost, Cam Fletcher looked okay. His minutes went down to 15, but he was 2-for-3 from the field. He finished with 4 points and 6 rebounds. Even though they did lose the game, Cam was still playing and he was being productive. After this game though, this is where our story takes the drastic turn. A lot of people think the downfall of Cam Fletcher was later than what I do, but I'm gonna explain why I think it was this game. On December 1st, they played against Kansas in a very close game and it was 65-62. They did lose, but it was a great fight. Cam only played 13 minutes this game and he went 0-for-2 from the field and 0-for-2 from the 3-point line, which means he shot only threes. He pitched in 2 rebounds and 2 steals and finished with 0 points, so basically he was a non-factor. If you're keeping up with these games, one thing you may have noticed is that his minutes are dropping every single game. He went from 17 minutes to 15 to 13. In this Kansas game, this is where I feel like John Calipari for some reason felt like he couldn't trust Cam Fletcher and he's not good enough to be out there. It has nothing to do with him not scoring, it's what happened in the next game. In the next game against Georgia Tech, Cam Fletcher only played 1 minute. Kind of odd, he was averaging 15-16 minutes per game, and then in the next game, he only played 1 single minute. I wish I had an inside report on it or something, but I just think that's very fishy. I feel like there's something that John Calipari saw in the Kansas, Richmond, or Morehead State game where he realized that Cam Fletcher cannot help his team, or maybe he had something against him. I don't know. We'll touch on that later in the video because John Calipari did one of the shadiest things I've ever seen a coach do before. After the Georgia Tech game and the next game against Notre Dame, he only played 4 minutes. Then to follow that up against North Carolina, and this is the biggest game for Cam Fletcher because I'll talk about it in a minute, he only played 2 minutes. Some of you are about to know what I'm about to say and get into, but during this North Carolina game and in the locker room, he had a quote-unquote mental breakdown. During this North Carolina game, Cam was really frustrated that he wasn't playing at all, so he was caught crying on the bench. That's all that we saw, and that's all that was put out to the public. But apparently something crazy happened in the locker room that even till this day, we don't know about. Something went on in that locker room that Calipari didn't like, and Cam Fletcher had another breakdown in the locker room. Something insane had to go on in that locker room because we already made a video about this, but John Calipari proceeded to suspend him from the team. And now we are about to get into what I still think to this day is the shadiest and just most terrible thing a coach could ever do. John Calipari, he's a great coach and I'm always giving him his props, but I do not agree with what he did. He went on social media, Twitter to be more specific, and embarrassed Cam Fletcher. He posted multiple tweets calling him out and saying why he suspended him. And here's my thing on it. You shouldn't be telling the media this stuff. This should be kept within the locker room. They don't need to know any of that, and that should be within the team. But here's what he said, because I know some of you are curious. John Calipari tweeted, "We have asked Cam Fletcher to take some time and step away from the team. He needs to reflect and do some soul searching to get his priorities in order. Any attitude or actions that are detrimental to this team will not be tolerated, and that goes for everyone on the team." He followed that up with this, "We have a culture here that's been built over the last 11 years and it will not be changed," in all caps. "Through good times and bad, this culture is meant to change individuals and change maturity levels. This hurts our team, but this is about Cam and his future." Following that up with this one, last but not least, "I talked to Cam and his mother and they know I care about him and I love him. But they also understand that there are changes that need to be made. It's his job to decide whether he can perform within this culture, both on and off the court." You can do what you want with that information, but all I got from that is that he threw Cam Fletcher under the bus. Basically saying he has a terrible attitude and all this. And even if he does, why are you tweeting it? We made a whole separate video talking about that situation, and even to this day, I don't understand why he did that. We're not going to talk about that too much. Anyways, let's continue on because we have some more stuff to talk about. And when he got suspended, a lot of people thought it was only going to be for maybe a week or two, but it was much longer than that. Here's one more thing I want to touch on too. Cam Fletcher was crying during the North Carolina game because he wasn't playing and he was frustrated. That means he cares and he's showing heart and passion. I have no problem with that. If you call him a crybaby or anything like that, that's just how I know you've never played sports competitively. If it didn't mean nothing to him, he'd just be sitting on the bench and not doing anything. But the fact that he was crying shows that he cares. Now, as to what happened in the locker room, it probably wasn't good, but for him crying, yes, it's not good and you don't want to do that on TV and national TV, but hey, it is what it is. It's hard for a player to be a 4 or 5-star recruit, be the man in high school putting up over 20 points per game, and then to come to a college and not even be playing. I get it 100%. Some of you can't relate, but just try to put yourself in those shoes. He went from being a star and a Michael Jordan of his school in high school to now just a random bum on a team. Was he a bum? No, but I'm just saying that because he wasn't playing. Then again, I also have this strange conspiracy theory, if you want to call it. I feel like him and John Calipari has some bad blood between each other. If you saw him play in high school in person or even just watched the highlights, you would understand that this kid was raw. And that's why he was playing at first. Remember, the first 3 games, he was averaging 15 minutes per game. So why, after those 3 games, and he was performing well, why in the next 2 games he only played 2 minutes? I could be completely wrong, but I feel like John Calipari had it out for him. The fact that he quit playing him out of nowhere for an unknown reason, and then he tweets all those bad things about him, there had to be something going on. Continuing on with our story though, eventually he wound up rejoining the team fairly quickly and much quicker than some people anticipated. But when he rejoined the team, there was a number in several games where he didn't even play. He went from being a guy in high school that was a star, and even at Kentucky he was putting up good numbers at the beginning of a season, to now a guy that was riding the bench. Let me just tell you something, if you want to get humbled quick, that's the way to do it. I almost feel bad for the guy because I know how much that hurt his ego. I know I'm saying it a lot, but when you go from being a stud to now a guy that's riding the bench, your swagger, ego, whatever you want to call it, is completely gone. After riding the bench, the next time he saw action after that North Carolina game was on February 3rd against Missouri, and he only played 1 minute. So even though he played in this game, he's still not doing much. Then the next time he saw action from the Missouri game was a month and 3 days later against South Carolina, where he played 6 minutes. I do need to note that the only reason he played in this game was because Kentucky was beating the crap out of South Carolina. He was playing garbage time and he went 1 for 2 from the field. He did score, but it was nothing crazy. Let me just show you the timetable. On 12/19, he played North Carolina. He got suspended. The next time he played was on 2/3, which is February. He only played 1 minute. Then the next time he played was a month and 3 days later on 3/6 against South Carolina. For the season, he wound up averaging 1.7 points per game and 1.7 rebounds. And for the season in total, he only appeared in 9 games. Maybe it's just me, but all this is so surreal to think about. I don't even know what to call this. I wouldn't even say he really fell off. It was unfortunate circumstances. But then again, he also created some of those. But then again, there's a conspiracy that John Calipari had it out for him. And as to no surprise, as soon as the season was over, he declared or announced that he was going to enter the transfer portal. Let me just state this. If you thought Cam Fletcher was going to return back to Kentucky, I don't know what's wrong with you. Everyone that watched college basketball and kept up with this kid and the team or knew anything about the situation knew he was gone. I am going to give credit to him because throughout all this, he kept his head held high and he never got down, and that shows true character and he's a true man. But however, with that being said, I still think there's something fishy going on behind the scenes with John Calipari and him. I could be gassing it, but I can't get over that out of nowhere Calipari just quit playing him. I'm not talking about after the suspension, I'm talking about before. I know I'm not the only one that feels this way, so let me know in the comment section what you think about all of this. us. As for Fletcher and what's next for him and where he's going to go, well, it's been reported that a ton of D1 schools have reached out to him since he entered the portal. It's also been reported and leaked that he's somewhat talking to Marquette a lot, and I think that'd be interesting. I don't even think he needs to go to a small D1 school. I think he'd be fine at a regular D1 school. I'm not going to say he's a great hooper because of what happened last year. I didn't get to see too much, but I'm pretty sure he's still a good hooper. From what I saw early in the season at Kentucky and his high school highlights, he can play major D1 basketball and be a good player. He was just in a bad situation at Kentucky, and he needs to get out of there. The only real question is, will he live up to the hype that he was getting in high school, or will he continue to fall off? I don't know, man. It's going to be interesting. Let me know in the comments. But with all that being said, that's going to wrap up this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys learned something. If you're new to the channel, what are you doing? We're on the road to 100K. We can't get there without you. Appreciate all the support. Thank you so much. And as always, let's be great. I'm out, y'all. Peace.